Welcome to Tanu Science. In this video, we'll learn the problems of art questions from chapter 1 of class 10. First question, two blocks of masses 8 kg and 2 kg respectively lie on a smooth horizontal surface in contact with one another. So this is two masses 8 kg and 2 kg contact with each other, which placed on the smooth surface. They are pushed by horizontally applied force of 50 Newton. So they are pushed by 50 Newton. Calculate the force exert on the 2 kg. So these 2 kg alone you can take separate. Now force acting on this 2 kg we have to find out. This one you are going to take it as F21. So force on second body due to the first one. So first of all we find out the net acceleration. Because the acceleration will be the same when 50 Newton force acting on this system, this whole system moves with the same acceleration. So for this F21, the formula is M2A. So A value we are going to find out first of all. So F is equal to here two masses. So MA, according to the Newton second law of motion, force formula is MA. Now F is equal to mass is a sum of 8 and 2. So M1 plus M2A. So A is equal to F by, it will go to denominator, F by M1 plus M2. This is formula for acceleration. Now we can find out this F21. F21 is equal to M2A. That A value is F by M1 plus M2. This is a formula for this question. So to solve this problem, you can start from here. Directly you can write the formula. No need to discuss these things. To understand the problems, I explained. Now F21, force on 2 kg mass due to the first one is equal to M2 value. This one take, M1 take M8, M2 take 2 kg. So M2 value is 2. Then force, net force acting on the system is 15. Then M1 plus M2. M1 value is 8. Already we know that this is M1 value. Then M2 value is plus 2. So F21 is equal to 15, sir, 30 divided by 10. 0, 0 cancel. So F21 is equal to 3 Newton. This is force exerted on 2 kg mass. Second art question. A heavy truck and bike are moving with the same kinetic energy. So same kinetic energy. Kinetic energy of truck and kinetic energy of bike same. If the mass of the truck is 4 times that of the bike. So mass of the truck is 4 times the mass of bike. Then calculate the ratio of their momenta. So momenta we have to find out, that is PT by PB. According to the question, both the kinetic energies are equal. We know the kinetic energy formula of MV square. For truck use a subscription TT. For bike 1 by 2 MB VB square. This 1 by 2 going to be cancelled. Now MT, so MT value is 4 MB. You can substitute here. So MT is 4 MB. VT square is equal to MB VB square. This MB going to be cancelled. Now VT square is equal to VB square by 4. This 4 will come to denominator. Take the square root. VT is equal to VB by 2. This VT value. Now we have to find out the ratio of PT by PB. So ratio of the momenta. PT is equal to MT VT divided by PB is equal to MB PB. MT, so according to the question, MT is 4 MB. So 4 MB, then VT we derived here VB by 2. And already the denominator there is MB, and VB. This MB, MB and VB, VB going to be cancelled. Now if you cancel this 2, 4 by 2, 2 to 4. So PT by PB is equal 2 by 1. If you take reciprocal, PB by PT is equal 1 by 2. That is ratio PB is PT is equal 1:2. This is the answer for second one. Third odd question. Wearing helmet and fastening the seat belt is highly recommended for safe journey. Justify your answer using Newton's laws of motion. Wearing helmet. So when you're driving a bike, we have to wear the helmet. Accidentally, if you fall down, due to the Newton's third law of motion, helmet exert force on the road, road exert force on the helmet. If there is no helmet, the injury on our head. So we have to wear helmet. This is based on the Newton's third law of motion. Next, fastening the seat is highly recommended for safe journey. Due to the inertia of motion, object itself will not change its moving position. If we apply brake to the vehicle tries to come to rest, but we are trying to be in the motion. So you may hit on the front part of the vehicle. To avoid that, we have to wear the seat belt. If we wear the seat belt, we will be also in the rest. So we will be in the safe. This is due to the Newton's inertia of motion. So wearing helmet is based on the Newton's third law of motion. Then wearing or fastening the seat belt. Fastening the seat belt is based on the inertia of motion. Thank you, students.